Porsche makes laptops? We were skeptical too, but after trying the Porsche Book One for a few weeks, we were surprised to find the Porsche is both a great 2-in-1 and basically the Microsoft Surface Book 2, which makes the Porsche the best 2-in-1 currently on the market. Surprised? We sure are. Now the Book One is not a real Stuttgart Porsche. It's a 2-in-1 created by Microsoft, Intel, and OEM Quanta. Porsche Design, the design group that provides the fancy work for other companies such as LACI, Huawei, and others, is branding this product as a Porsche Design exclusive, even though the laptops aren't being manufactured on the same production lines as Carreras and Cayennes. Also, according to a genuine German, it's pronounced Porsche, not Porsche, but feel free to say it however you want. Now let's talk price. At $2,500, it's aimed squarely at the 13-inch MacBook Pro and Surface Book. Specs include an i7-7500U CPU, 16 gigs of RAM, and a 512-gig SSD. You can spec a MacBook Pro with the same internals as the Porsche for the exact same price. Of course, the Porsche is a 2-in-1 with Wacom touchscreen, pen, flip functionality, and detachability. Compared to the Surface Book, the Porsche allows you to get into tablet mode much quicker. Flip the screen, and it's in tablet mode. The Surface required detaching the screen to use it like a tablet. Otherwise, many of the truths about the Surface Book hold true for the Porsche. Excellent build quality, killer screen release, and double battery good for 14 hours of battery life. Currently, the Porsche has a 7th gen CPU, unlike both the Mac and Microsoft, which are still on 6th gen. The Surface Book does offer dedicated NVIDIA 940M or 965M GPUs on certain models, while the Porsche does not, which is a little disappointing. This is one of the big selling points for Microsoft, and one of the reasons guys in the office have purchased the Surface Book. That being said, if the first Porsche model is a success, we imagine they'll follow in Microsoft's footsteps. Now, Porsche has talked a lot about the gear hinge inspired by Porsche race cars. To us, the gears look cool, but the convertible detachable functionality is where the real magic is at. Also, where other convertibles are a little funky in tablet mode, the Porsche's clean edges mean it folds flat without any strange gaps. This is kind of how all 2-in-1s should have been designed from the start. As for connectivity, Porsche added Thunderbolt 3 as well as an assortment of USB 3 and other connections, which, of course, puts it well ahead of the Mac, and even the Surface Book, which uses Mini DP and no Thunderbolt 3. Also, the Porsche charges via USB-C, not a proprietary connector. The only strange choice is the micro SD card reader, not full-size SD used by the latest cameras. The speakers are decent, but not class-leading, while the headphone jack is located lower on the tablet portion, rather than sky-high like the Surface Book. The 3200 by 1800 display is really nice, and the Wacom Touch functionality with the pen's 2048 levels of pressure will set it ahead of most other graphics-oriented PCs. We do wish they went with Porsche automotive finishes. The silver is really nice, but not exactly exciting, and we kind of prefer the matte magnesium of the Surface Book. Overall, Porsche and the OEM team behind it really did a fantastic job. Since Porsche is launching with a single model, we hope they expand the line to mirror their Surface Book sibling and include GPUs like a GTX 1050 or a 1080 Ti. We can dream. Otherwise, the Porsche really is the 2-in-1 form factor perfected. And while the launch model is premium, the Book One is priced in line with premium portables, meaning there's no Porsche logo tax. If this is the beginning of Porsche's entry into PCs, we're pretty excited to see what else they have to offer.